हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 11 कॉमर्स, वेलकम टू प्रोफेसर्स वर्चुअल क्लास ऑन स्टैटिस्टिक्स। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ टू फाइंड आउट अरिथमेटिक मीन इन ए डिस्क्रीट सीरीज। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ टू फाइंड द अरिथमेटिक मीन मीन्स द एवरेज इन इंडिविजुअल सीरीज। टुडे वी आर टेकिंग द केस ऑफ डिस्क्रीट सीरीज। सो यू कैन सी ए डिस्क्रीट सीरीज इज ए ग्रुप्ड डेटा where along with the values their frequencies or the number of occurrence means in the observation how many times a particular value occurs is its frequency and it is symbolized by the letter f, small f means frequency. So here value 10 occurs 15 times, value 20 occurs 10 times, value 30 occurs 40 times and like this. So here x, in the question itself the marks of the values that is x and their number of occurrence that is the frequency f both will be given. And because don't go by the complexity of this table, because in order to find a solution in all three methods, that is direct method, shortcut method and state deviation method, I have combined the table. But for a direct method we need only x, f and fx, three tables. So in this way you should try to understand. So in all these three formulas whatever aggregates are required we have put here in the table. That is, we require d, that is a deviation. Deviation means deviation of a value from the assumed mean. Just remember the concept of assumed mean, but we have already discussed in our previous class. Here we have taken 30, the value 30 to be the assumed mean. And we need d, that is deviation, d dash, that is deviation by common factor, and because all the values are divisible by the number 10, that's why we have taken the common factor as 10. Then f and x, multiply f and x and you will get the column fx. Sorry. Multiply f and d and you will get the column fd, and multiply f and d dash and you will get the column fd dash, and ultimately we have to find their sum, that is summation fx, summation fd and summation fd dash. Summation fx is 3100, summation fd is 100 and summation fd dash is 10. Whereas summation fx, which is nothing but the number of observation, is 100, which is also represented by the letter n. So in this way we first made the table, and after that just only we have to write the formula, put the values and find the solution. So come to direct method. The formula required for a direct method to find the average or arithmetic mean is x bar, that is arithmetic mean, is equal to summation fx. Means first you have to find f into x fx and you have to add that column and you will get summation fx by n or summation f. N is nothing but summation f, and when we put the value it becomes 3100 upon 100 and the answer is 31. Hence in this observation of 100 students their respective marks are given, and what we found is that the mean mark is 31. So whether you are using direct method or shortcut method or step deviation method, it doesn't matter, always the answer would be the same. And if you find a different answer, then be sure that somewhere or else you have made some mistake. So come to shortcut method. Here the formula used is x bar, that is the arithmetic mean is equal to a plus summation fd upon summation f, where a is the assumed mean and you have to take some value to be the assumed mean, and here in this series we have taken 30 to be the assumed mean. So a plus summation fd upon summation f, and when we replace the aggregates with values, what we find is the equation became x bar equal to 30 plus 100 upon 100. 100 upon 100 is nothing but 1, hence we got 30 plus 1 and the answer is 31. So, in direct and shortcut method, we used two different formula, but ultimately we found the same answer. The arithmetic mean in both the cases is the same. Now, come to step deviation method. Here, instead of D, we will take D dash. And how to find D dash? Simply see the table. To find D dash, we need to divide a common factor with D. And common factor, we have to select a common factor that the greatest number that is divisible by all the value should be the common factor. And what you find here, the all the unit digits are 0. That's why, of course, all the numbers are divisible by the number 10. So we divided and found D1. And f into D1 is FD1. Summation of D1 is 10. So when we replace the value in the formula A plus summation FD dash upon summation X into C. C is common vector. So replacing the value, we found the equation to be X bar equal to 30 plus 10 upon 100 into 10, where 10 is the common factor. And the equation became 30 plus 10 into 10, that is 100 upon 100. So equal to 30 upon 1, because 100 upon 100 is 1. So again we got the same answer, 31. The arithmetic mean or the average mark of 100 students to be 31. So these are the way how we find using different methods the arithmetic mean of a discrete series, which is nothing but a group data where along with the values their number of occurrence, that is their frequency, is also given. So in our next class we will be discussing about how to find arithmetic mean or calculate arithmetic mean in a continuous series. So that much for today. Thank you and have a nice day. Today, however, I am going to send you the syllabus for your half yearly exam. Thank you. Have a nice day.